Hey, Darren. Forgot to turn my speakers off. Almost got some nice feedback there. All right, let's go ahead and get this show on the road. So, hello and welcome to another Sunday edition of Retro Rank Rhapsody. We have a interesting game today. This is sort of a sequel to a game we've played. It's a game that's taken some of the elements from it, but it's a completely different style of game. That game that we're talking about, or that I'm talking about, was D, which is a very early adventure game, or game that, not early in terms of like game development. It was one of the first fully 3D adventure games that was one of its legacies. But it is a game that we looked at early on, and it hasn't really aged that particularly well. Originally for the 3DO, you're not going to have a whole lot of sacrifices would need to be made for make it, you know, work on a 3DO and being fully 3D. Also, just realize, no, this is not E, unfortunately. There is actually a literal sequel to D, which is D2, but that is not something that, that is not what we're taking a look at. It actually, again, is a completely different style of game. Also, I just realized, looking for D on my ranking list is going to be hard, because it turns out that searching for just D is probably a bad idea. Yeah, we rated it at 16. We looked at it in episode 76. So relatively early on. Yeah, I looked up Warp. But yeah, this is a partially similar game, but the main thing about it is entirely different. And it's rather unique. Unique is a good way of describing it. This has been described as a game that is either love it or hate it. I've been told that I'm not going to like this, although who knows, that we'll see what that is. I've kind of played the tutorial that comes with it, and I'm going to do it again just to show you how this game works. But we'll see. Another thing that is neat about this, going back to the development, this was helmed, obviously not entirely made by, helmed by one Kenji Ino, who was a really, he's actually, like, his musical things is kind of, if you look him up, he's actually labeled as a Japanese musician and not a game developer. He did do quite a lot of music. Not the music in this game, oddly enough. There's actually a really interesting story behind that. But there's also an interesting story about this game's announcement. So, Kenji Ino, I think it was either at Tokyo Game Show or was at E3, where he was giving a presentation because D was brought over to the PlayStation. Did apparently really good on the PlayStation. And he was giving an announcement to say, hey, we're making a new game. Warp Inc. is making a new game. And they had the PlayStation logo behind them. But then I believe that there was some, I don't want to say controversy, but there was some beef between Kenji Ino and PlayStation, or than Sony. So as the PlayStation was on the screen, it gradually turned into the Saturn logo. And they announced that their next game would be Saturn exclusive. And that game was this, which is Enemy Zero. Another concept of this game does star a character named Laura. It is not the same Laura of D, because what Kenji Ino wanted to do, if you're familiar with the manga artist Osamu Tezuka, you know, Astro Boy, Blackjack, and all that, you know that he reuses a lot of characters throughout his stories. Laura, the main character of this game, and D and D2, all share the name Laura. And Kenji Ino had the idea of what they called the digital actress, which was a similar looking character that could play in multiple different roles. So it is a similar character to D, to the one from D, but not actually D. They're the one from D. So yes, similar character, not the same person though. Other than that, before we get in, this game is 4 discs long, which is deceiving because, there's not, I think you can beat this game, and technically I am like 99% certain we're not beating this today, because I'm going to try and do this roughly a little bit blind. I do have the guide up, just so we can see at least a little bit of it. But I do kind of want to try this blind, at least for a little bit, and see what we can do. So I think that's that. The first disc of the game is actually the opening movie and also a training mode, which we're going to go through. So we're going to start with looking at the intro disc. If I hit the right button. Come on, there we go. I love the Saturn thing. Also, oh, I went the wrong one. There we go.
I don't know if you mentioned it, but the voice actress for Laura is the same as in D. It's Jill Cunniff of the band Luscious Jackson.
Oh, it is the same. I didn't actually know that.
Yep. I don't know if she did D2. I'm not going to look it up because I don't care.
I don't think it is D2. D2, I think, was post-warp? I mean, no, it was. I don't think it was. I think D2 had a weird different development cycle.
Oh God!
Yeah, good luck trying to read that.
I'm looking away because I'm actually getting nauseous.
There we go. It's done.
Thank you. We're off to a good start. This is very promising. Come on, Lolo, get into it. Get your glow sticks.
I appreciate them timing the banging on the monitor thing to the bit of the music.
This is definitely an opening.
Incredibly 90s. Also, it's great because this music is completely different than the style of the music that's going to be in the game. There's actually another interesting story about the music. I think I mentioned that, though.
This is not selling me on the game.
Well, good, because they already have your money if you're watching this. It's great, because I don't think this has anything to do with, like, this is a really bad way of selling what type of game this is.
Yeah. Oh. I see it.
You see what?
Nothing. You'll see. If you don't already know.
Yeah, right. Okay. Enemy zero. Okay, so I'm curious if this is just the same movie again.
Also, there's no line through it though, that's E-O.
Yeah. Nope, it is the same thing. Okay. I don't know why then they just give you an option to do it. So what we're actually going to do first, because it is in here, I feel like it is worth taking a look at. We're going to look at the staff. Oh, wait. Oh, okay. I was actually hitting the wrong button is the problem. Right, this is a Saturn. This is a Saturn controller, not a PlayStation 1.
Who wants to see the intro a third time? It's just the entire stream is you playing the intro over and over.
Well, eventually I've figured out what the thing is, because that definitely is not how that video bit starts. So here's the actual thing. So this is actually composed by a very notable musician, which I bet you they're gonna call it out real quick. This is actually a very interesting. Yeah, Michael Nyman is the composer for this game, who is a like actual like or like he is a very high level pianist, and like is the head of a well regarded orchestra. He has done things like. I believe he did the compositions for the soundtrack to The Piano, The Ogre, Gattaca. And the story apparently behind that was the fact that, so there was a bad earthquake that hit Japan around the time this game was developed. And Kenji Ino was a huge fan of Michael Nyman. So Michael Nyman happened at the same time to be, I believe he donated a bunch of pianos to various schools, or like music schools in Japan. And he actually came to Japan to see how basically his pianos were doing. Kenji Ino convinced him to talk to him and managed to, I don't know if it was, basically Kenji Ino went up to Michael Nyman's hotel room and apparently was in that hotel room for 6 hours trying to get him to do the music for his game. And at the very end, Kenji was like, oh, will you do it? And Michael Nyman was like, yeah, I'll just do it. I'll do it. And he did it.
Yeah, holy shit. He has a lot of work.
Yeah, he is a major level composer. Like, I don't want to belittle this, but this is kind of... This is punching... Getting Michael Nyman is a incredible gift.
Like it's a like bit. Having Mike Oldfield do your soundtrack for like an Atari game.
Yeah. But then again, this was CD medium, so you now actually had like actual, like not just like PSG or like something like that. You had CD level audio.
Yeah.
So I imagine that probably was part of it.
Giant turds in space.
Yeah, that's basically the gist of it. Darren, so yeah, this is... Go ahead.
I was going to say, I really hope we see the title more times. What were you going to say?
I don't really have anything else to say. Yeah.
Captain EO went horribly wrong. Very crackly.
Yeah, I bet you that's the Saturn. Also, I bet you the emulation's not 100%.
Yeah.
Actually, I am curious about something. Give me one sec. Wonder if I could See if I can do anything to maybe get this a little bit better.
Looked like this was his only game soundtrack.
Yeah, I would imagine. He did not do a whole lot of... Oh, why am I doing that? CD cache. Okay, that's probably a good thing to have on.
The ogre.
Okay. Let's go back to this.
Diary of Anne Frank.
Yeah, Gattaca was like the main one that I recognized.
Yeah, Enemy Zero is his only video game credit. Wow. Surprise, it's Samus. Got a bird.
Here's our backup.
I see. This is your watching movie.
Yep.
Icon. I like it.
Alright, there's the opening.
There's the title for the fourth time.
So there is some D footage. Yeah, there is gameplay. We're just going through the stuff. And yes, there's Kenji Uno. Also, there is a name in here that's actually fairly interesting. I don't think that's him. Nope, D2 hadn't happened yet. So Fumito Ueda, I believe, is the name. Yeah. So he is also responsible for a very notable game. Fumito Ueda was the head of Team Ico. So Ico, Shadow of Colossus, Last Guardian, that guy got his start on this game. Actually, technically, no, he got started at D, but he also worked on this. It's actually, apparently there was a quote by Kenji Uno that was talking about, like, oh, did you help him get, like, really big into the thing after making, like, Shadow of the Colossus and all that? He's like, no, he came in with talent. I didn't have anything to do with that. Mm. It's a very humble thing to say.
All right, sliding puzzles.
So I believe that Japanese-looking game that came, went in between, I believe that is Trip D, which is a game for the 3DO. Alright, here we go. So, now. Let's do the training. Because there is a very interesting mechanic behind this game, in this game's gameplay. So, a lot of this takes place in, like, a first-person maze perspective. And there are enemies, and you do have a gun. The thing is that the enemy normally is invisible. However, they give you tools to see it. That map is not a thing you usually get. But, as you go along...
Alright, so you get a little more free roam.
Yep. Mm-hmm. But then also...
I heard a ping.
Should start hearing a lot of more pings. Because, much like Alien, you have a sound sonar. So the thing is, faster it goes... Okay, there it is. Okay. So you have to time your shot because your shot takes a little while to go. So you have to use a sound rare to figure out where it is and judge by the sound where it is. Nope, it's over here.
Thought it was more to your left.
Oh shit. Wait. Okay, hold on. I'm trying to figure out. Yeah. Okay, let's. There it is. This is only for the Sega Saturn, yeah. Trying to get the used to.
On Windows, too.
This one? That might have, must have been after.
98.
Yeah, this was in 96, so that was well after this originally came out. Okie doke. So now we have nothing. Which is gonna be how the game normally works. Oh, that's great. See if I can isolate one of them. Okay, it's right over here.
I think it's behind you. No.
No, it's in front of me. Yeah, it's right there.
Ah, there we are.
Okay. Where's the last one? So the thing was is that usually they don't group up like that is the problem.
So what I'm getting is high pitch means it's in front of you. Mid pitch means it's to your side, and a low pitch is it's behind you.
Possibly. I know this, obviously the speed of it is how close it is to you.
Yeah. But every time you looked away from where it seemed to be, it's that's the low pitch. Kind of like a hot cold sort of thing.
And there we go. So, yeah, that is the main thing about that. So it's not the more you hold the gun, the stronger it is. You have to hold it out for a certain amount of time for it to shoot, is the thing. So let's start. So, okay, there we go. So, does that let me go ahead and see if I can get this to work? It's gonna be confusing. Check this, go to this one. There we go. Okay, now this is a good sign. The fact that it starts, goes to the menu. There we go. Yeah, it's just zero, so it's like, you put in disc one to like, okay, here's where the game starts. So let's see. We're gonna start a new game. So you have three difficulty levels. So there are some interesting mechanics behind this. The fact that it is a post Resident Evil survival horror game means that so this has limits to how much you can save and load. You have, like, instead of doing increments, which you have to find, you basically have a thing that allows you to save and load. The thing is, depending upon how much, or what difficulty you're playing on, your thing starts at a different percentage of how much juice there is in there, and it changes how, how much energy it requires to save and load, because it requires energy to load. So theoretically, you can final death your way in this. At least I think you should. I mean, theoretically, that would also mean that, yes, that's how you do that. So basically what these do is it changes level. On beginner, your thing starts at full juice. It takes 1% to save, 1% to load. I believe easy is the same. It starts at the full. However, I believe it's 2 to save, 1 to load. And normal starts at 60, and same thing, I believe. It also changes how much energy you have with your gun. Because I believe in beginner, you have practically infinite ammo. If not infinite, just a lot. And it basically gets lower the higher difficulty you go. There is actually no difference in terms of content between these three difficulty levels. So we're going to do on beginner. The thing is, if you beat the game on normal mode, it unlocks hard mode, which gives you even more limits. The thing is also with hard mode is that when you start the game, you get a scene of Laura taking a shower. That's it. So you can play on beginner. So it's not the true ending. It's the true beginning, I guess. So yeah, sometimes you'll start in rooms and you get the D experience.
Oh, it's just as slow.
Yep.
I'm going to walk over here.
Oh, I definitely realized it was made slow on purpose. But I'd imagine I'd want to go over to this thingy. Okay.
Vex was a good game.
Okay. Okay, I think this is basically just giving us kind of basic information. Kimberly. American. Counselor 32. I'll take B. We are apparently a co-pilot. I guess it's a tower. Parker, who looks like the person who died. Ronnie. It's Captain Pilot. George? Okay. David. Alright. Personal file. Not available. Okay. Yep, George is Japanese. Let's see. Information. Okay. I was about to say, I'm like, why is there the Laura room? Except I see that, oh, it's okay, it's everyone's rooms. Has rooms. I thought we were the only one with rooms. Steering room, locker room, storeroom, elevator. Oop, I'm gonna go. Wait, okay, I'm gonna go. Wait, I guess I can only go on the first floor? Power room, stair room. Oh, this is for winter. Okay. There. Lock. Okay. Let's see, can we call anyone?
Oh, so you can't fool me, that's a Simon Says with one less number, or color.
Wait. Wait, that's... I guess that technically is how you would romanize, or you would make... I believe that's how you would, romaji, or, like, transliterate Laura. Laura? Kinbari. Oh, gotta have their number.
Wasn't it 46?
46 was...
Marcus.
Mark, no, I think it was Parker.
Alright.
Oh, I guess we just...
Then it was probably Marcus then. Oh.
Yep, that was that's definitely Marcus.
No, that's Parker.
Yep, Parker. Yep. Okay.
I think he's dead.
Oh, he's super dead. Yeah, it's not Lola. Lola would just be Rhoda. The little dash means that you hold it, so it's Rhoda. Can we do something with the flowers? Okay. Let's go.
Maybe he's only mostly dead.
Attention. Attention. This ship's emergency mode has now been activated.
As I say, I thought that... I think that if I go straight and to the left, I think that's Marcus's room? Okay, I guess not. Whoop. Okay, question is... I do not have any sort of firearm.
Is it a door to your left?
Is it a door? Is that a... Oh, yeah, I guess that was a door, not just a wall panel. Okay. I think it was something around here? Oh, here's the elevator. Alright, there is no power, so we can't use the elevator. I hope you like really used footage.
I do. I thrive on it.
Okay, so nothing there. So I think if we go further down this hallway. I believe this was this one of these was the stair room, the other was something else.
I don't know, I'm completely lost.
Okay. You know it would be if I use look at this guide that's behind me, I wonder if they have a map. It is an entirely text-based guide. Great.
Okay. Well, then, let's see.
Charge system. Fix.
Think.
Let's see. Laura. What?
Okay, it's in a zip file. Oh god. Oh god!
Did you find something?
I found a zip file full of like 20 files.
And what is it that you're looking at?
There it is. Oh, it's because I made that small for the thing. Let's see here. Trying to find a map for you.
I think she's silent for now. I do believe she actually talks in those. Okay.
Oh my god! I'm posting this in fucking images. You tell me if you can make heads or tails of this.
Alright, give it to me.
There. There's your fucking map.
You know, that's... Okay, hold on, let me... I think I can actually work with this. Okay. So we're on floor what? Oh, maybe not.
Depends on what floor you're on. I'll show you what,
I also don't think this is the right tower. Because I think we're on winter.
That's what I'm looking at right now.
Give me, give me EMW1F.
EMW1F?
Yeah.
There. I think that's it. Winter Tower.
Yep, I believe we're on winter.
Terrible.
Yep, that's us. Okay. Yeah, because... Yes. Okay, this actually is where we need to go. Okay, so we need to leave here, actually, I think. Yeah, so here... So I believe if I go here, I think... Or actually, did I go in the wrong room is the question. So I believe... Is there a door here? Okay, so there's that. So let me just double check. So if we go here. That's a nothing. And that's the only door there. Seems like there should be a door, like, right here. Oh, unless I need to go back. Okay, I think I just need to go back. So I need to go here. And I think I already passed where I need to go. So here. So go there. There should be... That goes the elevator on the left. So go over here. There we go. There should be a door on the left. Should be right here. There is no endgame map. I think, because I didn't get my save device yet, so I think that I just need to find something first. Well, it's just another one of these. Okay, you know what? I think I've already hit the point where it's like, I'm gonna peek at a guide real quick.
Finding better maps. Oh, that's Metroid.
In the beginning, you will turn. Some of the things. Locker room. I'm sure you will find him. Been there yet? No. Okay, I missed something in my room, which is what I kind of figured.
Fuck off, AMC. I'm not going there. I get rid of that app.
Okay, let's go.
Actually, technically there are in-game maps, but they're at the machine you were at the start.
Yeah, I could go check the map there, but that's not practical when you're in the middle of the hallway.
Nope. Technically, you could go there, look at a map, and I could screenshot it.
I could do that.
Mm-hmm. For every map.
Okay. So apparently I was supposed to get something here. You know, also, I know this probably isn't everyone's, like... Oh, here. Well, here. Might as well just do this. No, I have not seen anything of Martian Gothic other than people talking about it, and I'm kind of curious, but...
I don't think it's bad, but... There's one person we know that if you mention it to him, he gets very mad. He does not like it.
Here we go.
I think it's a unique game, but I've never beaten it.
Can you hear me? This is Captain Ronnie. Things are probably rather confusing for you at the moment, since you were jolted out of hypersleep. It seems that something is happening on the ship. I want to discuss this with you immediately, so call me on the video phone.
Okay.
Laura, can you hear me? This is Captain Ronnie. Things are probably rather confusing for you at the moment, since you were jolted out of hypersleep. It seems that something is happening on the ship. Shenlong in the passing, it must... That's me, Steve. Yes, sir. Yeah, for that, the your wish is... One, but the way you're from Flicker, that real about person is...
In our room, that's it. In case you want to hear the Swedish dub of this game. And yes, your great friend did the LP of Martian Gothic, which I know Bear's talked a lot about. Okay. Let's look at those maps. Okay, map. Okay, there's one. You taking a screenshot?
Okay, screenshot is posted.
There we go. And here's basement one.
Basement one. I'll just get the map this time.
All right. I think. Yeah, I don't think we can get the other towers yet. Okay.
All right, I'm going to close this just ridiculous file.
Okay, now where is... Okay, so apparently there's supposed to be some drawers. Ah, there we go. That's the thing I was looking for. Okay, here we go. I think we're good. Okay. I guess I think I might have... How do I inventory? How... I like the look on her face when she just gets really confused by things. Nope. Oops. Okay, there's gotta be like a inventory system. Oh, I see. I'm gonna have a problem. One second. I forgot that I, for some reason, they bind the inventory menu please tell me you didn't crisscross crash. Okay. Okay, for a second I thought my charge just crashed, which would have been really bad. So they bind the thing to left and or the to R, which is my fast forward button. So I'm gonna have to rebind those real quick. There we go. I like that's the use item sound. It's a nice satisfying snap. Not quite the Windows achievement sound, but some similar. Alright. Now I got that. Is that my... Let's see, what do I have in my inventory now? I got that. Do I have like a thing that's like, hey, this is what... Because this is the thing that... Yep. I believe this is the thing that lets you save. So, record is save, play is load. Okay, now that I've done that, what do I need to do now? We'll find the pathways again. Apparently there's something behind a mirror, too. Locker room, gun charge wall. Car key, now leave the locker room and go for the stair room. I'm gonna head back to the my room because I think there's something behind a mirror I can take. Oh, I think I didn't mean to go there. I needed to get some rest. I think should be a door on the left. Yep, you, and then I'd go down that hallway. Doop, 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 bounce, 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 bounce. There's the storeroom, and here should be my room. Oh, I think that's, I think what we already took. I think so. I guess we already took that. Okay, so maybe we do have everything. Okay. Let's now continue where we're supposed to go. There. Go here. Now I take a right. And go down to the stair room. Okay, well, thankfully. Okay, so the stair room. Let's see, now that I'm here, I want to go this way.
There's quite a lot of first-person survival horror games. And they come in different varieties. You get your puzzle games, you've got your games like Condemned, Resident Evil 7 and 8.
Yeah.
Amnesia, Outlast, Layers of Fear, Alien Isolation.
Oh, right. If I remember correctly. So this is, I heard about this. So apparently there is a, let's see. Hold on one second, please. Shut down, turn it back on. Sorry. So It's... So apparently this puzzle is... not great. Because apparently there's no way to know the solution of it, you just have to, it is literally just guess it. Also, I'm curious about something. Can I do this? Okay, that is safe state. Okay. Hey, Elsie. I'm gonna do this real quick. So I wonder if this is gonna make it a little bit smoother. Because I know this can cause issues sometimes. Oh, wow. That... Oh wait, actually, is that, this actually...
Did you break it?
So, usually what happens is sometimes if you turn rewind off, it makes the game run fast. But here's, here's the problem when I turn rewind off. Is that the game's running way too fast, also there's no sound.
Could be a problem.
So. I guess I have to have rewind on. That being said, I'm gonna lower the buffer size a little bit. There we go, that sounds a little bit better. That's right, I forgot I added that emote.
It's a good emote.
Is that the right direction, or is that... Okay, good. So now power should be activated again.
Snake is inside that box.
actually just finished my drink, so let me just do this and then I'll go and fetch another drink. Alright, so, just do this just to make sure that time's frozen. So that, I will be right back. Hydration achieved. Yeah, it's a very slow burn game, which I don't exactly think is bad. Oh, do I have to do it again? Oh. After the first one, it's like, oh, hey. Okay, let's see. Three two six. No, this does not count as an FMV game.
Sensors are detecting a life force on level one. It's not human, it's something else. Proceed with caution and go investigate.
I'm just checking something. All right. Yeah, it would have been real nice if he was still around. But yeah, unfortunately, Kenji Ino passed away in 2013 to heart failure. Yeah, no, the lady on the, Kimberly did, whoever Kimberly's character is, definitely did not show up in D1, because D1 had two characters, I believe, in it. Oh shit, I think I got myself lost. Oh, here. There's a power room.
We mentioned one of the other notable names in this, Fumito Ueda. But also, I'm reading now, Takeshi Nozue worked on Final Fantasy VII Advent Children, and Ichiro Itano worked on Macross.
Hmm. Okay. Yeah, I'm pretty sure we are now into the game proper. Pick that up. Okay, let me see.
Delicious.
Oh, we need a DNA code. Hasn't someone done like a test to see if you could actually, if this would actually work on like biometric stuff? Weapon.
Wow. finally make shoot.
It's a real video game now. Now give me 1 second. Give me a second. Here you will find the canteen and inside you will find the much needed gun. Okay. Okay. Well, I think we were doing mostly the intro stuff for like the first 30 minutes. So yeah, it takes about an hour to get the gun. Okay.
So I'm reading up a little more on the game, and there's a full quote from Eno about his interaction with Nyman, if you're interested.
Sure.
I like Michael Nyman a lot, and I like his soundtracks, so I was thinking that it would be awesome if I could get him to do the music. I thought that would be impossible, but it'd be great if that happened. Then there was this big earthquake in Kobe, Japan in 95, and Nyman was donating pianos to schools in the city. When the earthquake happened, he said he wanted to check how the pianos he donated were doing, so he came to Japan. When I found out that he was in Japan, I invited him back to my hotel room and tried to convince him for 6 hours to come work with me. So at the end, Michael was like, okay, I'll do it, just let me go back to my room. So he went back exhausted after being convinced for 6 hours. We didn't work out terms or conditions. He just said that he would do it.
Yeah. So also apparently I read that it turns out that some of the music that he made for this was actually reused some of his stuff from some of his previous soundtracks.
Yes. So the song Confusion is a modification of something from The Ogre. Enemy Zero / Invisible Enemy / Battle Theme are modified portions of Man with a Movie Camera, and the main theme is a variation on Bird Ant. Eno was an interesting character.
Also, one thing I really wish that Dia had the same exact problem, but I really hate the fact that it isn't smart, or like it's not smart enough to realize where, when you like have, like, you need to use the item with it. You can't just use the thing and then it's like, oh, I have this, so I'm just automatically going to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Also, technically, now that the game has started, and I probably should have done this earlier. Okay, hopefully this takes me to, because I need to go in the basement and I need to hunt a monster.
also important to note that what you did before was charge the gun, so the guns do have ammo and need to be charged.
Mm-hmm. Which, there we go.
You.
All right, here we go.
In.
What? So there, that's the game over message. It's also weird because it seems like you can't back up. Yeah, it's weird. Okay, so it's a little weird when, so I think it's to the right. What the? Huh? Okay. There we go. Yeah, it's a little screwy when it's in open areas, apparently. Been there. Oh, that's the power room.
Oh, wow. So, more information about the saving mechanic. You have limited saves.
Yep. Yeah, I think I mentioned when we were talking about the difficulties, I think I was talking about, I don't know if it was super accurate, but basically, yeah. Saving usually costs more than loading.
Saving costs 3 battery units.
That's on normal, I believe. In beginner, it only costs 1 each. Or one for both saving and loading, at least unless the video I watched was lying. Or wrong, rather.
According to Hardcore Gaming, it's just a straight 3 across.
Hmm.
And you get 99 charges on easy, 64 on normal, and
yeah, that's yeah, let me, well, can I not? Oh, and here I can't.
You can only save during the,
yeah, those things. Okay, so I want
explore room sections.
Yeah. shortcuts, apparently. If I go here... Oh. Yeah, because you tried to go to the elevator, there is a monster that you're an enemy that you cannot avoid it. Okay, now we can go here. Crap.
Laura, can you hear me? It's Kimberly. I'm watching you through the surveillance camera. The ceiling duct.
Oops.
Laura, can you hear me? It's Kimberly. I'm watching you through the surveillance camera. The ceiling duct should be I'm watching you through the surveillance camera.
Okay. Hold on, how am I supposed to...
Laura, can you hear me? It's Kimberly. I'm watching you through the surveillance camera. The ceiling duct should be open.
India, that is. Okay. Say right here. And yes, this is unplayable if you can't hear.
Laura, can you hear me? It's Kimberly. I'm watching you through the surveillance camera. The ceiling duct should be open. Climb through it and get out of there.
Oh, there we go.
Laura, right now you are in between the fourth and fifth level. I'm on the fifth level. You can get here through the emergency hatch. Watch out, the hatch is located on the other side of the tower.
I really hate how much you cannot back up. Nice. I take it that this is probably going to be locked. Yep. Yeah. Just reminds me, I can now save. So yeah, they used one energy. Let's see if I try that again. Check. Also, did I get a gun again? I think that's a gun.
Looks like gun.
Or is it just going to get the same video over and over again? Okay, looks like it's going to be the same thing over and over again. Oh, if I touch the computers themselves.
I don't like the way she holds things.
Yeah. Also, I saw some guide about fun thing about this gun. One shot per recharge.
Oh, that's good.
So can I open this more now, or... Okay, I guess it's just... gone. That's what I can... Oh, do I have to do in the deck system? Like, that looks like a door there. I guess I have to leave. Do you still have that zip on you?
I can probably... Yeah, I can just control J it. What do you need?
I think this is probably... EMW4FW, maybe?
Let's see. It's literally just a passage. It's... an L shape.
Oh, okay. What's the other one?
We got 4FE, which is another L shape.
Okay.
Okay, there's an actual, there's a guide here that tells me what each map is.
Wait, I just heard something open. Okay, this opens, but it's emergency. Also, I guess on beginner, this one has... Oh, right, I think in beginner you get infinite shots, so...
Forced out of hypersleep. Girl, I was expecting to wake up and see the clear blue sky of Earth. Hey, you saw it too, right? Well, I guess you really wouldn't say saw. Maybe feel is more like it. I'm telling you, something is moving around this ship. Something is happening. I wonder what's gonna happen to us. Anyway, our first priority is to establish communication with the other five crew members.
Give me one sec. Oh, this only has the... Alright. I was looking up IMDb to see for voice cast, but it only has the Japanese one. No, let's see. Oh, actually, yes, there is something. Where is it? There it is. President only gives me those two maps.
That's because you're still in winter.
Yeah, but I don't have like the floor for this one, or the map for this one. Oh, okay.
Laura, you're not harmed. Thank goodness. Guess you're tough enough to manage without me after all. I got hit pretty hard from that earlier job. The summer tower is relatively safe for now. Doesn't look like I'll be too mobile with these injuries. Could you maybe arrange it so you'll be able to head over this way?
Good thing he's all right, isn't it, Laura? You know, girl, he really is a pretty dependable man. You could rely on him, you know what I mean?
Put the map up in images.
Yeah, true. Okay. Okay, let's see. I'm going to do this because I saw something in the guide that I'm somewhat concerned about from a mechanical standpoint.
I got hit pretty hard from that earlier, Joe. The summer tower is relatively safe for now. Doesn't look like I'll be too mobile with these injuries. Could you maybe arrange it so you'll be able to head over this way?
Awful.
Good poster.
Mm-hmm. That's what I'm gonna do. Okay, I guess not. Guess I have to make more video phone calls? Or maybe...
Guide says look at Ronnie and Parker for a while.
Dream, and now this. Laura, you knew about me and Barker, right? Why? How can this be? There's no way you'll ever understand. Your lover. David is still alive.
Talk to David.
Yep.
I thought you were going to be so cold as to pretend to have forgotten about me again. You know that even back on Earth, you hardly ever called me. If it hadn't been for this situation, there probably wouldn't have been any hope of you and I getting together. Maybe for us. This was a fortunate accident. Laura, as long as you reach out for me, I want to be there to support you. I really want to see you. I'm waiting.
Hey, Rose.
Hey, Laura. Why don't we go to the Summer Tower? Look, I'm sorry about losing it earlier. But there's no point in being emotional at a time like this. I'm sure Parker would be upset if I gave up now. If we go to the Summer Tower and hook up with David and George, we might be able to pull something off. But, Laura, in order to get there, there's something you must do for me.
Okay, so here's where it's going to look a little bit interesting. Oops, wrong one. Not that one. Because I hit the wrong button. Alright, hit save state. So here's the question. If I do this... this might actually be it, because I might mechanically be unable to play more of this. Yeah, that's what I was afraid was going to happen, but let's see what happens.
Emulation. It's a fickle.
So resource. The problem is that whenever I load in a new disc, it resets the console.
Ooh.
Oh, good. Good.
We can get to hey!
The tower from the emergency bridge. There's a nuclear reactor there, so we can't go shooting off the wrong weapons. Laura, when it comes to taking on the enemy in combat, I know what to do. Tell me, do you know what the most crucial thing is? It's to stare your enemy in the eyes and never, ever look away. Just like taking care of a baby. That's right. This time, our enemy is nothing but a spoiled little brat. Up ahead, it's crawling with those creatures, the enemy. You stay here, okay? The door up ahead at the end of the corridor won't open unless the password is entered into this computer. The password is written in the front of the door, so I'll go up there and take a look. When I get there, I'll transmit the password. Stay here and open the door. Don't worry, it's fine. This is personal. Yeah. I want to finish them off with my own bare hands. Let's do it.
You know, my husband Parker kept this little blue canary in his room on Earth. Imagine a guy with his face cuddling a canary. Pretty funny, huh? Whenever he woke up in the morning, the first thing he always did was stand in front of the bird cage by the window and feed his bird. With those massive hulking hands of his, he would gently give it food. When we got this mission, he was so upset over being separated from his bird. He broke down and cried. You would never think he was like that, huh? We ended up taking the bird outdoors and letting him go, but Parker had regrets. He said that maybe we had let go of our little blue bird of happiness. Hey, let's drop it. I shouldn't go on like this. Parker wouldn't. So it's you. You killed him, didn't you? Where are you?
I like that it's using in-game assets. Oh, I thought she like kicked the door down or something. All right. Also. All right, here we go.
Having fun?
Mm-hmm. We just got to the second disc.
Oh, nice. Yeah, sorry, I love when people make a shitload of noise outside my window because it makes me sleep later, because, like, it wakes me up, I'm like, ah, fuck this, and I go back to sleep repeatedly.
Yep.
I had a shit sleep last night, I just kept waking up.
Same, but that's because of other people on my part.
Yeah. I was having weird dreams that I didn't want to have, so I kept waking myself up, which sounds weird, but...
It's fine. I had a vivid dream about eating a sandwich, so, like, I fucking feel.
Okay, but that's a good dream. I kept, like, dreaming I was in this really creepy room where, like, it felt like a ghost was coming in.
Okay. But the thing is, it was a vivid dream about eating a sandwich, but I didn't quite finish the sandwich, so when I woke up, I reached out for the last piece of the sandwich.
Do you remember what kind of sandwich?
Something involving buffalo chicken.
Ooh.
That's good. Except
that's actually
it was good.
Okay. Really good. I have wrapped around.
Yeah, Elsie, there was like one last bite left. And I didn't have it.
You're lucky, Torpid. It was the Brood Witch. If you'd ate that last bite, you'd be gone forever.
No, it's fine. I took out the sun-dried tomatoes. That shit's nasty. They offered me a free surgery.
It's a weird fucking show.
That was honestly one of the best episodes, in my opinion.
Let's see.
Yeah, like when they had a good episode, they had like the Danzig episode was really good. Yeah.
I still love the Foreigner Belt. Foreigner Belt was really fucking good.
It was. Normally I don't like the Moon Knights, but that episode's pretty good.
Yeah, that show was really hit or miss, but when it hit, it was really solid.
Yeah.
Yeah, so what do you think of the game so far, Lolo?
I actually think it has D problems when you're dealing with that. Like, there's just like, okay, I kind of wish that if there was a thing that required an item, that it just automatically did it. But other than that, the combat's a little finicky. But I like the concept of it. And I feel like this is better than most of the other, like, horror games that you see on the Saturn outside of, like, Resident Evil.
You mean it's like a lot of Kenji Ino games where it's interesting but clunky as shit?
Also, now I got a new gun.
Because that's what it sounds like to me.
Yeah, oh yeah, oh, this game's clunky as shit, but it's kind of neat.
Yeah, that's his games in a nutshell, honestly.
Mm-hmm. Did, like, I would say miles above Deep, which is not saying much.
No, Deep was a frustrating experience.
Yeah, I think his most, like, functional game was D2.
Well, that was
the best game.
I know the stuff's intentional, but the slowness of every single scene is just too much.
See, I'm one of those people that actually don't mind, like, it being slow. But I can definitely see that being a turnoff for people. Like, it's something about the fact that it's, like, full motion like this. Also, do I have control or not?
No, it's she's just looking.
Okay.
In this game, everything takes just a little bit too long. But no, I think it works for, like, the tone of the game, even if it doesn't feel great. Look at that hand! Look at that hand!
Look at that finger.
I actually would like to see you play D2, because D2 is actually, as I said, like, his most game, and pretty interesting. What I want to do is play D4.
There are 9 4
I have that. I should probably do that at some point.
It is a really neat game that will never be finished.
Oh, great.
It's a fucking tragedy, because I actually really like it.
Okay, how do I need... Okay, what floor do I need to go to? Okay, I think I just need to go to the top level. So, just to explain how this works, this is selecting the floor in binary. So, theoretically, this should be 0, So one, let's see, one, two, or one, three, two, I'm guessing.
What floor are you going for?
Well, I need to go to top, so I'd imagine that it'd be this seven. One.
I don't understand binary, so I would, this is where I'd like.
Binary is actually a lot more simple than you'd think. It, but like if someone just throws it at you, it's really confusing.
Yeah. It's basically a lot of like going back to your school, like elementary school lessons on, what's the name of the thing?
How good are you with powers of two?
No.
Well, also like, what's the thing with like the zero, the ones, the two, the tens, the hundreds? And all that, like the places, I forgot what they're called. There's a term for it.
No, no, I was thinking of it in terms of powers of two.
And yes, it is powers of two.
If it's math, it's no good for me.
Yeah, no, I can understand. It's fairly basic math at the very least, but yeah, I can feel.
No.
Yeah, so I've always been decent with like mental arithmetic, so it comes to me naturally, but
okay. Two.
Left and right.
Three.
Hmm? What are you doing?
Oh, just... oh, wait.
You have to enter it all in binary.
Okay, so to be.
That'd be middle.
Maybe yeah, middle. It's
left, right.
Yeah, left because there are four.
And then left, middle. Excuse me, right,
two,
middle.
And then middle,
and then right.
God damn it! Oh, go to done. Yeah, there.
Ah, it's super finicky.
There we go.
Dumb as it sounds, Iceclaw, one of my methods I used to use for, like, sort of, focusing and clearing my mind was actually reciting Powers of Two internally. It's dumb nerd shit, but it worked for me because it took my brain off things.
See, I just think of Power of Two when I think of I just think of size of, like, SD cards. And, like, how they expanded. Oh, actually, good. We can get more maps. Although we're going to be playing for like 10 more minutes.
I don't need to do that anymore, but it was work. It worked.
Is this one of these computers, or is it a different kind of computer?
When dealing with social anxiety in a bathroom full of people, just recite Powers of Two to get rid of your shy bladder.
And the floodgates open. Let the dam break!
Usually around 2048 is where it starts to work.
Okay, so there's a calendar. And I always hate it when it, like, swings past something I want to take a look at, but I know that it just means that it's not, like, needed, but still. Oh, here we go. Here's another computer. Okay. Wait, this is a terrible password system.
To enter the computer, you need to rate your pain.
God. I know what you're talking about. I always, those forms, they make you fill out.
So bad, right? Those fucking smiley faces.
Like, I liked it better when it was just, what's your pain level at a 1 to 10?
My problem is, like, I hate rating pain level because, like, pain is such this nebulous concept. And I'm like, I don't know. Especially because I'm a weirdo who just powers through pain anyway. So, like, the concept loses meaning to me.
It's also great because it's like, I had a thing where I think that I've pinched something in my back. So, because I was getting weird pains, like, in my nerves. And I was like, okay, I don't know how painful this is. But then, as I was going on, I would I guess just the sunglasses.
Put them on.
Let's see, is that an item here? So I was getting weird pains, and I'm like, I don't know how exactly how sore this is making me, like, I am. Then I kick the shit out of, or something with my foot on accident. And I'm like, oh, that's actual pain. Okay, I guess my chest wings aren't as bad. Okay, I can look at the thing here.
It's like, all pain is relative, so rating it on a 1 to 10 scale is like 9 possible for my brain.
Let's see.
Especially because, as I said, like, I'm the idiot who powers through pain. Like, I don't even take, like, painkillers like Tylenol half the time.
Power scanner.
Like, yeah, even so much as, like, the hint of a headache, I'm going right for the, Tylenol.
That was really good about sourcing on the migraine, because I just wouldn't take anything like a fucking fool.
Mm.
We found
so
it on
I just
calendar.
Sit there in like intense pain. I'm like, yeah, whatever, okay, let's do this.
Can you look at it further?
Look closer.
It says that the clue for the password should be here.
Yeah.
Can you look at the bottom part?
No, I think that's all I can do. I don't know. Password and the clue to get it can be found in the on the calendar.
What if the real calendar was the friends we made along the way?
Okay. It also doesn't help that the FMV has, like, the resolution of, like, 20 by 15.
It's real bad.
Because it's one of those lovely guides where it's like, oh, the password can be found here. And that's not why I'm using your guide. I'm using that so I don't have to look for this shit. I want you to tell me what the password is so I can save some time. Unless it's this thing that's near it. Oh, hold on. I wonder. Okay, what's this gonna do?
Aw, yeah. Consume.
Okay.
Sad.
Okay, that's that at least makes me feel better. So I'm like, I better not have to like read something like that. Also, that is an incredibly convoluted password system. Oh, God damn it, that's the wrong computer.
To open this computer, how are you feeling on a scale of 1 to 10?
I don't know why they don't let you wear. Do they let you wear the sunglasses?
I don't think they let me do it.
Counts.
We're wearing sunglasses in my heart.
I was gonna say that would probably require a half a disc of information just to get that thing over again. Okay, it was sad, medium, and then pain.
You wear your sunglasses at night so you can. Ah, smiley.
Don't mess around with the gallon shades. Oh no.
Okay. Vehicle. Anything about Bernie's? Oh no. Capture enemy.
Welcome to garbage data.
Let's see. Transporting enemy is hiring for permanent, regardless of the life of crew members.
That's a bad idea.
X minus A!
I do appreciate that she reacts to, like... Because I was watching a video review that was saying, it was like, you know what's actually kind of interesting in this game, the fact that Laura actually reacts to reading something that's kind of messed up in a way that a person actually would. It's like, oh yeah, we're just carrying this shit, and they don't care how about the
entire crew is fucking easily throwawayable. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's literally just alien.
Yeah, pretty much. Okay, so
it's the alien if you had a gun.
And okay. You couldn't see it.
Oops.
What
oh.
What do you need the sunglasses for?
Oh, there is one of these here. Let's see. Now, are you going to give me a decent map?
No. Video phone.
Six.
And honestly, you may as well blow up the ship.
Payload bay, tank area. Oh, okay. Fall tower, the winter tower. Oh, we are in the... Right, we are in the summer tower. David and George. Okay.
These maps are terrible.
Yeah.
The George room.
You should look in the images and other nonsense to see the other shitty maps we were looking at.
Oh, I saw before I hopped in. Before I got out of bed.
Okay.
Popped out of bed, said I gotta get me on that RRR.
Let's go talk to David and George, and I think we can probably call it after that.
It was more like I hopped out of bed, just went, I need a drink, and some food. And then I went, I gotta hop on RRR. Sorry, there are priorities greater than you, Lola.
Oh no, it was like this morning I practically did the same thing when Bear was taking a look at demos for stuff.
I immediately just hopped in the call, like, yeah, I just woke up. I fed the cat first, because, I mean.
Alessa is much more important than any of this, it's true.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just a fact.
My mom hates how much I prioritize her, because I literally prioritize her over my own health.
Well, your mom ain't shit. Alessa's where it's at.
Like, I've spent thousands of dollars on Alessa's health care, and I get angry that my doctor wants to make me pay $120 for a visit.
Also, to be fair, Alessa's been a large boon to your mental health, so...
Yeah.
Also, Shark, the PSO's 2 story mode is bad.
It's all cutscenes and then occasionally a fight.
Oh yeah, I skipped all of it and it still took fucking forever.
Yeah, you're spending more time in the menus than you are in anything else.
And you have to do every little bit of it. Every little bit. If you want to get the ultimate ending.
What? The ultimate what? The door was fucking loud.
Ending.
Okay. It's like, right as you were revealing what it was, the door just goes...
Where you and your waifus all come together to defeat the ultimate evil.
I like how the sides of the doors look like there's bloody thumbprints on them.
Oh, also, we're probably gonna get some dialogue.
Star Vega, the answer is Star Gems. Shark Vega, the answer is, Star Vega. Star Gems.
Laura.
Come on.
I was worried about you. You look a bit dazed. Did you bump your head?
Yeah.
The others? Well, we still haven't re-established communication. But there are more fatalities.
Sir, how are you not dead?
Laura, just think of your own safety, and you'll be fine. It's not a good idea to venture out. But I am programming a key disk for the Fall Tower access. Wait for me a bit. Listen. Those enemy monsters are vicious. Don't even think about trying to fight with them.
How are you still alive?
Alright.
I mean, you're right, Shark Vega. That's because there is zero content.
Thank you.
Yeah, it was like, oh, right, I probably should have done my dailies today, but then again, it's like, oh, I don't know if it really
Yeah, I've
matters.
Just been prioritizing the, Genshin Summer event. I need that swimsuit.
Laura.
Gasp. Sir, no, you're gonna poke her eye out with your nose.
Acting!
Man's nose takes up like half his face.
Stare off into the middle distance.
And that's what I do when I hug someone.
Contact.
The thing I hate about this is for some reason, just because it's on a space station like this, I'm just remembering the last thing that happened in VLR that you were streaming.
You mean the flipping?
Yes. In the time pod, so they didn't have to animate it.
They did do the fucking intertwined fingers as a euphemism. God, I love, like, the audio clipping.
Yeah, I don't know if it's the emulator.
It's
what?
Probably the emulator.
Thanks for the kiss now. Ah! His nose got bigger somehow.
I like the idea, just every scene his nose
ship,
gets slightly
Doctor
larger.
Tower.
Just cut
escape on that.
Every shot.
Was George in
ever
room?
So slightly.
I hate to, but we should run this by him as well. I'll go and check on him. Oh, you need to know. There's a vital concern in regards to escaping from here. It's about you and me.
It'll never work out.
I'll tell you when I get back. It's okay.
No!
This actually is about halfway, I think.
I've never been blueballed so hard in my life.
Okay. Also.
And there. I play fucking Zero Escape games for fun.
It's more masochism than anything.
The first two were fun.
At least you're gonna finish it on Thursday.
Dumpster fire. Yeah, it's gonna end. We're almost there.
Beep, 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 beep. Boink. Boink.
There we go.
Okay.
Legs. Okay.
I love this game's like fascination with smiley faces. There, we can save 96 more times. Because we are smart and playing on beginner. And anyway, I think that is a good enough look at Enemy Zero to kind of get the gist of what this game is. So
it doesn't get any better, really.
Yeah, I am curious about what happens later on, but that's not going to be unless someone validates it. But yeah, that's going to be that. So let me also save state. Okay, do. So. Let me also close it because I will leave RetroArch open in the background until about 5 days later until I realize I still have it open. So I'm going to close it down now. Okay. So. Where's my music? Where's my music? Okay. We had D at 16, so I feel like that game is much better than D. The thing is, though, just with the weird jankiness of the combat, it's simultaneously better and also a game that would kind of probably piss people off a lot. I can see why this is a very love it or hate it kind of game.
My complaint is how slow and clunky the cutscenes are.
Yeah, so the thing that I'm thinking this might be a 666 game because I feel like it fits right in the same place as like Overblood. And like Dr. Hauser, and like, I was gonna say, do we have a few horror games in here?
It's like everyone's moving through this layer of, like, gelatin. Just how slowly and weirdly they move.
Yeah. Because it's like, I don't think I can say that the gameplay is good, but I do think it's at least interesting that enough that I think you should try it. Like, just...
It is, well, it's like a lot of Eno games where it's got some interesting ideas, but the actual execution is intensely flawed.
Yeah. So I'm thinking 666 for this one. Because other than that, I would say... If I actually was putting a number on it, I don't think that much. Like, D was at 16. You're thinking 15 or 16?
Like 13 or 12.
I was gonna say, we don't have that. We actually don't have that many survival horror games. The ones that we have are the weird ones. It's definitely not like Silent Hill. Just kind of trying to look at 14. It's weird because
like Jeopardy.
Jeopardy and Mario teaches typing. And Mickey's
Karnov.
And Karnov. Yeah, I think if it was a number, I'd probably say about 14 or 13 or 14, though I do feel that it belongs in 666.
I won't fight it either way.
Yeah. Also, like, SOS, another game that I feel like it would be really neat if it weren't for the fact that the mechanics can completely bog it down.
Yeah, well, that's because it's fucking human entertainment.
Yeah. And just like this is Warp.
Let me tell you about fucking human entertainment games, everyone.
Especially the one that you might be playing now. And how many times did you have to play that one thing?
3 times the same damn day.
I need to take a look at that. I'm probably going to do it around... I think... I don't know, like... I think I am. I need to think about what I'm doing, like... Because I think I actually am streaming on Christmas this year. I think it falls when I normally... I do that.
It is a Christmas game.
Are we gonna do Silent Hill 2 this October?
I gotta think about what we're doing in October, because there's some weird timing in that. Because I know... There's something that happens in October that I know, because I'm actually... I know that I'm actually streaming in October, or on Halloween this year.
Yes, that's
but it's
Sunday.
It's gonna be a Sunday, though, so it's gonna be early in the day.
Mm-hmm.
So this technically is a horror game. So I gotta think about what to do. Where's the horror theme? There it is.
You're streaming all Halloween weekend on in October.
Yeah. I know that's when, because also my birthday, that's also my birthday falls on that Friday, so I already have planned what I'm trying to do. I just gotta figure out mechanically how to work it. Anyway. I feel like the music is really good, which, go figure, you get Michael Nyman to do your soundtrack. And it's gonna sound good. Like, a extremely high-level pianist and, like, orchestra leader. Yeah. Gameplay, I'm gonna put the light bulb. The art, I am just gonna leave blank because I feel like it looks fine for the era. Like, it doesn't look good, but it also doesn't look bad. It's not like D, where it was extremely early level 3D. This just feels normal. Difficulty, I'm actually going to give this one because just by the nature of how the combat works and also the limitations, it is
that's
a harder game.
Use the guide.
Yeah. Storytelling, it's normal. And charm... this game isn't really campy, so I don't think it gets that. It's just, it's a weird game.
Mm-hmm.
Also,
it's not
definitely
campy, it's just really badly written.
Yeah. Also,
like
it
many
is.
Things, it's clunky.
It's sluggish. Yeah, that's like
oh,
the.
Oh, very.
Also.
I don't know. That's like, it's like all the fucking signs of Kenji Eno in, like, both the best and worst ways.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, also I'm going to put Moon Logic because the first puzzle is literally guessing it. But yeah, I think that's good for Enemy Zero. It's a neat game. It's just kind of it's a Kenji Eno game.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I think that is good for that. Anyway, that is going to do it for this episode. So let's talk about what we're doing on Saturday, because hopefully we're able to continue Hazeltown Story on Friday. And I am actually very much looking. I keep on forgetting that this is what I'm doing on Saturday, but this is what I'm doing on Saturday, because I keep on forgetting this game's coming out so soon. So, thank you all for watching. You can follow my personal Twitter, at LoloDePuzzlo. There is a Discord in which there's a couple polls determining what we're doing in actually next month. And like for stream stuff, you can also chat with the community. It is a Discord channel. After all, there's also Patreon. $25 tiers helps with hosting costs and various other things. If you're watching this in a VOD, or if you're watching this on YouTube, you can go to my Twitch channel, twitch.tv/LoloDePuzzlo. These episodes are recorded live Fridays at 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time, Saturdays at 2:30 p.m. Eastern Time, and Sundays at 1 p.m. Eastern Time. If you are watching this live and you want to see past episodes, you can go to my best way to watch them is on my YouTube, which youtube.lsp.life. New episodes are uploaded Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. This one will be uploaded on Friday. There's also two exclusive shows, Media Delta and Hazeltown Story, which go up on the YouTube and also the podcast channel, which you can find at radio.ldp.life. New episodes are uploaded at 8 a.m. on Thursdays. So, next Saturday, Mario Golf Super Rush comes out, and I am very much into the idea of a new Mario Golf. So, that is what we are going to be doing. Also, that Wario costume is great.
Checkered pants are always a win.
Yes. Also, yes. Anyway, I'm going to go send you all over to Bear, who's taking a look at in his countdown to the new Alex Kidd remake coming out. He's taking a look at Alex Kidd Miracle World ROM hacks, which I am, unless he is doing that solo, I'm going to go and help go commentate that, because I am also very curious about that. So,
well, with that.
Yep. Have a good time, whatever time it is when you're watching this. Morning, afternoon, whenever. Later.
Bye-bye.